on in there, or did you snatch it off the table in there?
It's your head.
No, you got it.
They're dead.
Oh, shit.
You run to the truck.
Yeah.
There's another truck.
Central.
The typical welcome home.
That is awesome.
That's all good.
Yeah, thanks.
All right.
7 long ago. She just left.
Mom ditched her.
So I'll go get her and
Sure. Yeah, you want to do an interview thing?
Yeah, we got a microphone.
Cool. How do I look? My best side?
Yeah, wearing the hat.
And yell into the mic? It's great to be home!
Chris! Hey, brother, good to see you. How are you doing?
Good to see you.
Awesome.
Alex.
What? How you doing?
I'm all right.
How's the crazy job?
It's crazy.
Different?
Oh, shipyard is.
So did you catch what the call sign for your guys was? Top hook.
Well, I caught that.
So they're like, top hook, farting. I'm like, and the funniest thing, we're in the brief, and the guys are going, so is that call sign Felix, or is that the other?
Okay.
Do you want me to go back and set up?
What's up, Mike? Hey, do you want a 105?
Howdy!
Good to see you, man.
Thanks.
Hello.
How's it going?
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Hey, she got your jacket.
Dude!
She's right there.
She's huge!
Yeah!
Ow!
They're a lot bigger than you said they were.
Huh?
I promise I'm not this tall.
Thanks, sweet.
Screw it, all three in.
They're good.
I tell you what, let me disconnect.
Yeah, disconnect.
Is he doing?
Mic check. Are you getting good audio?
Yeah.
It's about 40 pounds worth of gear.
This is 40.
Yeah, something like that. That should be nothing for you.
You can't get an authorized stick. Guys off the ball box.
Oh, yeah.
How are we doing?
How you doing?
I'm doing excellent.
You guys left many, many months ago with one idea in mind of what was to become of your lives, and then the world changed and you had to pivot and respond and answer the bell. Talk about that.
Well, you know, we got trained for an entire spread of missions, and as we left, we thought we were going to Afghanistan to do that mission, and we did for a couple months, and then within 30 hours, we swung around, went to the Gulf, and within 30 hours, we were launching an aircraft into Iraq, doing armed overwatch, non-traditional intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance, and defense of the personnel on the ground, as well as humanitarian assistance support. So a different mindset, a shift, but exactly what we were trained for. And thanks to the sailors, we got it done. The sailors were amazing, and they made it work for us.
What does that flexibility say to you about these men and women that hold up the right-hand volunteer?
You know, the flexibility inherent in the Navy is everything. And that's, you know, we're where we're needed, when we're needed, and that shows the amazing flexibility. And the sailors and the families and the friends that support them, that's the true magic of the Navy.
Can you give us a sense of when you left and you turned over to Vincent? You left them in good hands, of course, but did you make a difference over there? Is there anybody to quantify that you did some good?
I do think we made a difference. As you looked at the folks on Sinjar Mountain who were safe because of us, the Mosul Dam that was back in the rightful hands of Iraq, working with the Peshmerga forces and the Iraqi security forces, and then some of the work we did in Syria and other places, I think we definitely made a difference, and it was a seamless transition, which speaks to the standardization between aircraft carriers and carrier air wings, with carrier air wing 17 taking over for carrier air wing 8.
Can you talk about what was different between when you had a pivot from what you planned on doing and going into your new mission, but strategically or mentally, what was different?
Sure, for us in the cockpit, not a lot different. because you're concentrating on the rules of engagement and your procedures. The only big difference was we didn't have ground joint tactical air controllers, so it was done from the air, which speaks to the technology and the capability of the United States and our coalition allies in the region to get things done. And it also speaks to the teamwork of the USS George H.W. Bush Carrier Strike Group 2, Destroyer Squadron 22, and the USS Philippine Sea that made that maritime security operations happen while we were doing the operations in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Home in time magically for the holidays.
Magically for the holidays. Yeah, and you know, we're just excited to be home in the Hampton Roads area with all the communities that support us, and happy to be home with our families and friends.
While you were gone, Admiral Greenard and a couple of others were talking about the length of deployments that the Navy goes on. This was 9.5 months. He says we really want those to come down. How difficult are those longer deployments in terms of either maintenance or just kind of keeping your edge?
Sure, it's a little more difficult to stay a little longer, but that's what the Navy does. We're there as long as we're needed for what we're needed for. And I think they're doing a great job of whittling those down and looking at exactly what the right amount of time at sea is. But the support of the family and friends and the local community is really what made it work for us. Good?
That's it.
Awesome. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. Thanks very much. We're home. Thanks.
Yeah, head over by, yeah, you can just get, walk in and get a few more shots.
Ha ha ha!
the dry water, it's a concrete slab.
I'm sorry.
There's a tally light on.
Yeah.